Welcome back to part 4 of Youcat. This week we will continue to learn about prayer and how to pray.
Before we start, let's ask our Blessed Mother to intercede for us, as she is a powerful intercessor and an exemplary model of someone who knows how to pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Long before they learn to say yes, toddlers often learn how to say no. If you don't think so, spend some time with some 1-year-olds, 2-year-olds, or even 3-year-olds and count how many times they say no. Of course, no is not all bad. In fact, there are plenty of things in this world to which our best and safest response would be a big and resounding no.
But that never applies to God. As Mary, the Mother of God and our Mother, teaches us, when it comes to God, we must always have a prayerful attitude of yes. She teaches us in her last recorded words in the Gospel to do whatever Jesus asks us to do, which is always to say yes in word and deed to the will of the Father.
What is an important lesson about prayer we can learn from Mary?
To learn from Mary how to pray means to join in her prayer. Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Prayer is ultimately a self-giving in response to God's love. If we say yes as Mary did, God has the opportunity to live his life in our life. What are the 5 main types of prayer?
Blessing and adoration, prayer of petition, prayer of intercession, prayer of thanksgiving, prayer of praise. What does standing in prayer represent? What does kneeling represent?
Standing in the presence of God expresses the reverence. You know, you stand when a superior enters the room. And also vigilance and readiness. You're ready to set out onto a journey immediately. If at the same time your hands are outstretched, then that assumes a praise position, also known as the orante position. It is the original gesture of praise. Now, by kneeling, a person makes himself small in the presence of God's greatness. He recognizes his dependence on God's grace. What reasons did Blessed John Paul II give for saying the rosary was his favorite prayer?
The rosary is my favorite prayer, a marvelous prayer, marvelous in its simplicity and in its depth. In fact, against the background of the words Ave Maria, there pass before the eyes of the soul the main episodes in the life of Jesus Christ. They are composed altogether of the joyful, sorrowful, and glorious mysteries, and they put us in living communion with Jesus, through, we could say, his mother's heart. At the same time, our heart can enclose in these decades of the rosary all the facts that make up the life of the individual, the family, the nation, the church, and mankind. Personal matters and those of one's neighbors, and particularly of those who are closest to us, who are dearest to us. Thus, the simple prayer of the rosary beats to the rhythm of human life.
In Luke chapter 1 verse 28, we hear Angel Gabriel's greeting of Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." And in Luke chapter 1 verse 42, we hear Mary's relative Elizabeth greeting her with the following words, "And exclaimed with a loud cry, 'Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb.'" These words make up the Hail Mary prayer.
St. Paul speaks to us about who intercedes for us in the letter to the Romans. Who is to condemn? Is it Christ Jesus who died? Yes. Who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword?
St. Paul gives us more advice about prayer in Colossians chapter 4 verse 2. Devote yourselves to prayer, keeping alert in it with thanksgiving.
Recite the rosary today with your family or with a friend.
Turn to Mary, our mother, each day and ask her to teach you how to pray as she does.
Learn the mysteries of the rosary. Let's go through them now. The joyful mystery of the rosary. We pray this on Mondays and Saturdays. First joyful mystery, the Annunciation of the Lord to Mary. Second joyful mystery, the Visitation of Mary to Elizabeth. Third joyful mystery, the nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ. The fourth joyful mystery, the presentation of our Lord. The fifth joyful mystery, the finding of the child Jesus in the temple.
The sorrowful mysteries of the rosary, we pray this on Tuesdays and Fridays. First sorrowful mystery, the agony of Jesus in the garden. The second sorrowful mystery, the scourging at the pillar. The third sorrowful mystery, Jesus is crowned with thorns. The fourth sorrowful mystery, Jesus carries the cross. The fifth sorrowful mystery, the crucifixion of our Lord.
The glorious mysteries of the rosary, we pray this on Wednesdays and Sundays. First glorious mystery, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. The second glorious mystery, the ascension of Jesus Christ to heaven. The third glorious mystery, the descent of the Holy Spirit. The fourth glorious mystery, the assumption of Mary into heaven. Fifth glorious mystery, Mary is crowned as Queen of Heaven and Earth.
The luminous mysteries of the Rosary, we pray this on a Thursday. The first luminous mystery, the baptism in the River Jordan. The second luminous mystery, the wedding at Cana. The third luminous mystery, the proclamation of the Kingdom of God. The fourth luminous mystery, the Transfiguration. The fifth luminous mystery, the institution of the Holy Eucharist.
How's your prayer life? You may have never been asked this question in your entire life. But it's also a question that we can't be afraid to ask our Catholic and Christian friends. In fact, if you find a friend that is bold enough to ask you that question and help you stay on track, then you have definitely found yourself a friend indeed.
Prayer does not come naturally to us fallen human beings. Even myself, I struggle with prayer. And sometimes it just takes a lot of effort to sit down to pray, to have that communication with God. But Adam used to walk daily in the Garden of Eden. That's the biblical analogy, used to say that Adam had a conversation with God, had a relationship with God almost every single day. But one of the first and most devastating losses caused by the sin of Adam is that prayer does not come naturally. It's a struggle, a battle, a work that requires the grace of God and a humble heart, and a heart that is willing to persevere. And we need our Christian friends to encourage us, and we in turn need to encourage them. So, how's your prayer life?